So we will study about separation of mixture. We have started studying it. Now we will try to separate the mixture of salt and camphor. What is actually camphor? You may be knowing already. Salt and camphor. Okay. So there are some substances which are converted directly from solid to gases without changing it to liquid. They are called sublimates. They are called sublimates. Okay. So there is one called ammonium chloride, is there? Ammonium chloride. Okay. Then there is anthracene, is there? And there is one more chemical called naphthalene. I think naphthalene balls you may be knowing very well. Naphthalene balls. Okay. So these are what sublimates means. Actually, these are the compounds which will directly convert from solid to gases without changing into liquids. But how do we separate? Suppose if they give mixture of ammonium chloride and salt. Because ammonium chloride and salt have same texture. If you touch them, both of them are same. But when they mix and give and tell them to separate, how will you separate them? Okay. We use one simple method, like heating. For all we use heating only. But there is little difference in this. What we do here? Okay. I'll draw a diagram here. Just it will be little clear. So, this is a stand, tripod stand. Okay. So we take the given mixture of what? Salt and camphor or sand and camphor. Salt and camphor. Here salt and camphor. So they have told us to separate this. We have to separate them. Okay. So this will not directly, if you eat, you will not get camphor. You cannot get it because directly it converts from solid to gaseous state. So what we do here, we use a funnel, but that funnel we keep in what? Inverted, right? We keep it as inverted funnel. We keep it in the inverted position, inverted like this. Upside down, we keep it upside down. Okay. Now, to this upside down again if you keep and start heating. Okay. Start heating. What happens here? This will escape. Camphor will escape. Because directly from solid go converts into gaseous state. So to avoid that, we use what? Cotton plug. We use cotton plug. So there, when you start heating, salt remains there only. But this camphor converts into vapors. Okay. Then after converting into vapors, we'll stop heating. After heat, stopping the heat, heat supply to the system, these camphor particles are attached. They will go and fix to the, because when you cool, gaseous state converts into solid state. Solid to gaseous state, gaseous to solid state. In this way, we are able to separate salt and camphor or salt and sodium. So ammonium carbonate, ammonium chloride. In this way, we are able to separate the mixtures. Okay. I think if we label is, this is tripod stand. Okay. Tripod. This is China dish. This is funnel which is inverted. Okay. So these all are vapors of camphor or vapors of ammonium chloride. Okay. So after cooling, again you will get back the camphor as it is. Okay. So this is one simple experiment where we can separate two mixtures. One is generally salt and one is camphor. Okay. Now we'll try to find how will we separate two miscible liquids. I told yesterday only what are immiscible liquids. Immiscible means which do not mix with each other. Immiscible means which do not mix with each other. Mix with each other. Okay. Miscible liquids means what? Which will mix with each other. Means mix will, which will mix with each other. Okay, immiscible liquids and miscible liquids. Now what we are doing here, we are taking miscible liquids. The best example is we are taking water and acetone. What is acetone? Do you know? Where we are using acetone? I think we apply nail paint all, mostly girls. Okay. So to remove the nail paint, we use a liquid available in the shop. So that liquid contains what? Acetone, which has less boiling point. Boiling point will be very less. Suppose if you open and keep that acetone bottle, after 10-15 minutes it will evaporate. It is not available to see because its boiling point is less. What we do here, to separate the mixture of miscible liquids with boiling point difference, where there is boiling point difference, more difference is there. Means water's boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius and acetone's boiling point may be 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. So difference is more. Okay, so what method we should use? They give mixture, just they give one what test tube and they give both in one only. It looks like water only. They are completely like water only. Okay, so acetone and water is separated by using a method called distillation. What is distillation? It's a process where we are able to separate the mixtures by the help of boiling. Okay, what we do here? We take a round bottom flask, like this, a round bottom flask. Okay. So how to measure temperatures? You can't keep any stick and measure. You can't see just until water is coming out, somebody that acetone is boiling, you can't recognize. So we scientifically, what we use here, we use thermometer. We use a thermometer where it will indicate the boiling point. Okay. Again, this is connected to one more beaker where it is collected. This side. Okay. So again there is a tripod stand is there. Again there is heat. Again there is what? Acetone and water. So this is actually called bent pipe, test tube. Everything is made up of glass. Okay. Here, so directly we can, what we do here, again there is one more structure like this. But why we should use this one? See, this is actually continuous flow of water will be there. There is, again this is connected to the pipeline. What? This is actually condenser. Because you know very well, water when it boils, it becomes vapor. Again, when it cools, water vapor becomes water. Same way, so when you start heating, first, which will boil quickly? Water or acetone? Okay, acetone boils quickly because it has less boiling point. Due to less boiling point, so first, who will come outside? Acetone will come outside and this will convert into vapor. So when vapors come in contact with this condenser cooler, that becomes a liquid and acetone is separated. We separate two miscible liquids with higher boiling points by a method called distillation. This is one simple method where we are using distillation method to separate mixture of acetone and water. Okay, suppose again there are two liquids where the difference in their boiling points is very less. One is 45 degree, one is 25 degree. So what we do here, there is only one simple same structure is used, but here we use one more extra structure called fractionating column, and which is made up of glass beads will be there. Glass beads like this, glass, it is made up of a glass beads. Because why? Because all of these all are made up of what? Mixtures with lesser boiling point. Both of them are in boiling point, very less, very nearer. That's why is here. Okay, but this structure, this is called fractional distillation. By using fractional distillation, we are able to separate two miscible liquids with a lesser difference in their boiling point. Okay, here we are able to, we can take acetone and one more liquid which has nearer boiling point, so which has again very less boiling point, which will, it will come out. Which has more boiling point, it will boil, it also will come out, but it will stick to the glass beads. There is a glass beads like marble, glass beads. Okay, so this will attach here and slowly it will go really cool, really. But if it is having 10-15 degree, it will come outside and convert, undergo condensation, then this becomes liquid. So we separate two miscible liquids which have lesser difference in their boiling points, and one is earlier we separated two miscible liquid which have more difference in their boiling points. Okay, these are two simple experiments. Now we will try to find see children again, is it possible to get oxygen from the air? Because air is everywhere, you see. But before that, you should know air is a homogeneous mixture. Air is a homogeneous mixture. Means where we are unable to find where is air, where is carbon dioxide, where is nitrogen, where is oxygen, we can't find. So for this we are using a simple method called fractional distillation, where we are able to separate at different temperatures. So first what we do here, air is compressed and cooled. Compressed and cooled. How will you compress? Compress by increasing what? Pressure. Increasing pressure. And how will you cool? Decreasing temperature. When you decrease temperature, automatically the system will cool. Decreasing temperature. Okay. So this is one part. Again, this will undergo distillation. Where what happens here? So here we get liquid air. Here we get liquid air. This liquid air will undergo fractional distillation at different boiling points. I told already, fractional distillation is nothing, it is a boiling process with different temperatures. Fractional distillation, it will undergo, and this will, from here, after fractional distillation, this will go undergo what? Condensation. After the molecules of air are converted to liquid, again that will undergo vaporization by fractional distillation. Again, depending on the temperature, we are collecting them at different heights. Lastly, we collect oxygen, because liquid oxygen is very important for especially hospitals. So if we want to separate oxygen from air, we have to undergo all these processes. So first what we do here, there is one simple diagram. Okay, so as I told already, first air is compressed. There is compressor, like this. Compressor should be the compressor, press, okay. So here, where is, what is coming? Air. So air is coming, and it is, this is, air has become hot. When you compress air, that becomes hot. So what you should, cool the air. To cool the air, again, we are using what? Cooler. So again, this will undergo cooling process.
where the air undergoes cooling process, it becomes cold. Okay, so again, see this is this outlet here. Here water. Okay, so again this is. Again, this is compressed, cooled again. Again, after cooling, here this actually called compressed air. Okay, so the compressed air will undergo. It will go to a tank called separator where there is. Because it is cold. Temperature reduced. Here, what happens in this separator? From this separator, actually, we get solid. Or dry carbon dioxide, solid carbon dioxide means what? Is it carbon dioxide from the air solid? But little difference is there. Solid carbon dioxide is nothing, dry ice, we call dry ice. This will come to later. Okay, so separator is there. So again, from there, what happens? Again, this will undergo liquid jet expansion. Jet will be there. All the molecules will expand. These all molecules will. Expansion jet. When they expand, so there is one fractional distillation tank. So when they undergo fractional distillation, here we separate argon, rare gases. We separate rare gases from the air because they are very rare, and less in number per less percentage. And after separating all this through this, lastly we get what? Liquid oxygen. So in this way we get liquid oxygen by a simple method of fractional distillation. Okay. Children, we try to find how we can obtain pure copper sulfate from its impure sample. An impure sample is given to you. They will tell to remove the pure one. Get it pure form. So what we do there? Usually that sample which is impure form, that is converted to solution because that is usually highly concentrated. Okay, so from highly concentrated solution, what is done here? So concentrated solution of what? Copper sulfate is taken. Okay, so from this we have to remove impurities and make it pure. We have to remove the impurities and make it pure. So simple technique, directly evaporation not possible because when you evaporate, most of the impurities remain with them. So what is done? First it is completely heated. But before heating, that is completely, after heating, it is covered with filter paper. We need to cover with filter paper. All the impurities will attach to the filter paper. Okay. So I told already, this is concentrated solution, means which is highly saturated. Then only we are able to go for crystallization method, which we call crystallization method, where here actually what was, you know, when you remove this, filter paper is removed, that completely filter paper will absorb the pure total impurities and this copper sulfate crystals will get in a pure form. So that's what we call what? Crystallization. Crystallization process in which we are able to get the crystals in the form of pure crystals from a solution. Okay. For example, seawater. From seawater, what we get? Salt we get. Salt is completely impure. Completely it is brown in color. So directly if you go take salt and put in water, it will not evaporate. So many impurities are there. So for that method, what we are using? We are using same crystallization method where we are able to separate the impurities and where we are able to get salt in pure form. Okay. So where these are used? These are used in industries especially. Okay. So see, even in sugar also, manufacturing sugar in the sugar industry also, it has impurities. So to get pure form of crystals of sugar, it will undergo crystallization. That's why we are able to get different types of crystals in the sugar industry. Okay. After filtering, suppose you take completely saturated solution and you take it for filtration. When you filter it,
then also there is impurity, more impurity. So best method for getting any salt in pure form is crystallization, the process where we are able to get crystals in a pure form from its concentrated solution. The condition of crystallization is whenever it to any liquid for crystallization, it should be completely concentrated. Okay, thank you. Some questions I will be giving later, you can solve it.